Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss about the curriculum or syllabus of Advanced Diploma in Industrial Safety. So this Advanced Diploma in Industrial Safety is the course which is affiliated to MSBT, that is Maharashtra State Board of Technical Education, Mumbai, and under the state government. So the syllabus which I am going to discuss is with effective from the 2017-18. So the previous syllabus are different, and now this syllabus is called as G scheme syllabus for the EDIS. It is a short term course, state government approved, and non AICT course. The duration for this course is 1 year duration. The pattern for this course is yearly pattern, and it is implemented from 2017-18. The teaching examination scheme for this Advanced Diploma in Industrial Safety is, there are 8 theory subjects, 1 project and 2 practicals. So in this contents, the each and every subject title is having some subject code, subject abbreviations, and teaching examination means there are contact hours allotted for the subjects. Like this, 2 hours allocated for industrial safety management, 1 hour for tutorial, and there is no practical for this subject. But in the second subject, 2 hours for theory, there is no tutorial, but 2 hours allotted for the practical. So in this way, there are 16 theories, 6 tutorials, and 8 practicals allotted for the 8th theory and 9th project. So final examination contains 100 marks theory paper, 50 marks passing, that is 50% passing is required for this MSBT EDIS course, and there will be final MSBT external examination, that is oral examination, and that is of practical subjects, that is industrial safety engineering, and second is industrial hygiene and occupational health, and third oral is depends on the project work. Then term work is allocated, or the 50 marks weightage is allocated for the project report, that is called as term work in the technical world, and sessional work is also there. So this sessional work is nothing but the class test marks. So each class test is having 25 marks weightage, and there are 8 subjects. So 25 marks into 8, that is 200 marks, and for 2 class tests, that is 400 marks. So this 400 marks is going to convert into 100 marks, and you will get the marks or percentage out of 100 for the class test. So in this way, this 100 theory sessional or class test marks, then 50 term work, then oral 150, and 800 theory marks. So total 1100 marks weightage is there for the EDIS course. Now there is a fixed structure for each and every subject. So they have given the course name, course code, then the year of this course, then the subject title, then subject code, teaching examination scheme. So in this, again here it is repetition that 2 hours for theory, tutorial 1, there is no practical hours, then the paper is of 3 hours, 100 marks theory is there, and total 100 marks weightage for this particular subject. Now here the common guidelines for all the subjects, that 2 tests each of 25 marks is conducted by the MSBT. Total test marks of all theory subjects are to be converted out of 100 to be entered in mark sheets, and under the head of sessional work. So SW stands for the sessional work, and it is of class test marks. Then 8 assignments pertaining to the subject shall be completed in the tutorials. So assignments are there, class test is there, and final examination is there. Then rationale, objectives, and the learning structure is given for all the subjects. So I'm not going to discuss each and everything for all the subjects. I just introduce you what exactly the contents or what is the structure of the MSBT syllabus. So this is the learning structure, where it is a bottom-up approach, that is the facts, concepts, principle, procedure, and applications. So these are the parameters on which this learning structure depends. So we have to study this particular parameter, and going upward, we have to apply this knowledge, which is absorbed from all the types of parameters like facts, concept, principle, procedure, and we have to apply this knowledge in the industry. So this is the learning structure for all the subjects, right? So there are 6 chapters and the structure is fixed for all the subjects. So the first chapter is having weightage, that is 20 marks, and remaining 5 chapter is having weightage 16 marks. So 16 into 5 chapter, that is 80 marks, and plus 1 chapter, first chapter is 20 marks. So total 100 marks weightage is there for each and every subject which is under the ADIs, right? So in this first chapter of industrial safety management, that is having code 23108, 14 hours is allocated by the MSBT for this contents, for delivering these contents, and the weightage is 20 marks, right? So in this first chapter, introduction of the management, role of management in industrial safety, then organization for safety, directing safety, communication, then national policy on safety, health and environment at workplace are the main keywords for the first chapter. Then in second chapter, it is going to focus on the safety education and training. So there are different types of trainings involved under the education and training, but it is related to safety only. Then the third chapter focuses on the employee participation. That participation may be the regular activity or weekly activity, monthly activity, or there may be the competitions which are organized by the industry or organized by the DISH, MPCP, etc. That may be the government or non-government or semi-government organization, and in that participation you can go for the different activities like poster presentation or essay writing, etc. Then in the fourth chapter, behavior based safety and conflict and frustration are the main keywords for the fourth chapter. So we have to study this behavior based safety to reduce the incident or accident ratio and to avoid the conflict and frustration, or to reduce the stress in the work environment. We have to study this conflict and frustration part. Then in the fifth chapter, it is focuses on the MIS, that is called as management information system. So there are different activities where we have to collect this information or data, and we have to manage this data. So how to manage this data, that is the techniques or the different techniques or the latest technologies available for this purpose, and we are going to study all these techniques or MIS in the fifth chapter. In the sixth chapter, we are going to study the accident, the definitions, different terminologies, and how to prevent that accident. That is the main motive for this purpose. We are going to study the different models or techniques involved, some IS like IS 3786 for the IS classification likewise. So these are the 6 chapter for the 23108, and here the list of assignments is given in the syllabus. These are the guidelines. We can directly absorb as it is, or we can modify these assignments, and students have to complete these assignments. Then in the syllabus contents, they have given suggested learning resources for your references. You can opt your own references, but these are the guidelines where we can refer. For example, this industrial accident prevention, and the author of this book is Henrich. So you can refer this book, and the publication of this book is McGraw-Hill Company. Likewise, you can refer all these learning resources references, and you can check the satisfaction level for your requirement of the contents. Then the second syllabus of ADIS is safety in engineering industry. So the subject code is 23109. The teaching examination is same. The notes and all the instructions are same for all the subjects. Then they have given the rational and objectives, and again the learning structure for the subject, right? Here again that bottom up approach, facts, concept, principle, procedure, applications are given. And now the exact contents of this syllabus for that particular subject. So in the first chapter, we have to focus on the machine operation and guarding. then safety in the use of machines, then safety in use of hand tools and power tools, then hazards at workplaces. So these are the different concepts which are involved in the first chapter. The second chapter focuses on the material handling and storage. So material handling and storage may be manual, may be mechanical, and some equipments or some trucks, lifts, etc. can be used while we are handling this material, or we can while handling the storage of this particular material. Then third chapter focuses on the plant layout. What exactly the plant layout? What are the parameters or concept to design that plant layout? Then what is meant by housekeeping? What are the different references for the housekeeping? Normally we are referring the 5S techniques, that is Japanese techniques. So these are the different contents in the third chapter, that is plant layout and design. Then other contents like boiler operations and thermic fluid heaters are also involved in that same chapter. So we must know what exactly the boiler is, then with the working of boiler, then different parts of boiler and the hazards. And in the same way, we must know about the parameters for the thermic fluid heaters also. Then in the fourth chapter, electrical hazards at workplaces, then what is the concept, that is static electricity, how it is harmful to the industry, then what is meant by lightning, or what is the functioning of lightning arresters. These are the focus for the fourth chapter. In the fifth chapter, we have to study the safety aspects in engineering industries and the different operations or processes involved in the industries like melting, molding, machining, etc. And the hazards at workplaces. So what is meant by hazard? What are the types of hazards? How to identify hazard at workplace? So that different concepts involved in this chapter, and that is specifically for the textile industry, then agro industry, sugar industry, dock operations, etc. Then the hazards handling in at cargo. So at the in the dock operations, what are the operations involved on the dock, then the while handling the cargo, and what are the hazards involved, and what should be the prevention techniques. So these are the contents for the fifth chapter. Then the sixth chapter focuses on the destructive, non-destructive testing, heat treatments, and safety concern for the IT and electronic industry. So we have to study in two parts. The first part is destructive, non-destructive testing and heat treatment, and second part involves the safety aspects in the IT and electronic industry. Then again, the assignments or topic given for the particular subject, then some learning resources are also given for this subject. For this subject specifically, they have written the IS publications, because in many cases some operations, some guidelines, some classification is basically or should be referenced from the IS only. So IS are the main guidelines for particular operations. Say for example, code of practice for the selection, installation and maintenance of wire ropes. So you must refer this IS 3973 for this particular operation, and likewise you can refer the remaining one. The next subject is construction safety, that is 23110. The again same notes, practices, instruction, rational objective, learning structure is given. Then the main chapter is first, that is safety in construction industry. It is having the contents like hazards in construction sector, what exactly the sector is, then their preventive measures, then safety in the use of construction machineries, then good safety practices or initiatives in the construction safety. Second chapter focuses on the type of construction activity, working below ground level and working at height. So these are the two parts where the construction activity and safety practices should be mentioned. Then the third chapter focuses on the safety measures at the ground level and underwater portions. So for some industries, there are some operations which are underwater, and that is why these safety measures are required for these underwater portions. Then the fourth chapter focuses on the special works like high-rise building, bridges constructions, canal construction, railway constructions or maintenance, etc. Then the fifth chapter is focuses on the specific, that is special precautions, especially for the distillation column, silos, then transmission communication lines, cooling towers, cable car installation, etc. So this is the specific point and specific instructions or precautions mentioned under the fifth chapter. Then the sixth chapter focuses on the demolition operation. So you must know what is demolition, then the what are the safety precautions and measures should be taken for the demolition operation is the sixth chapter. Then again the assignments list is given, then the learning sources are given and some references are also given. The next title is chemical and process safety management, that is 23111. The instructions, rational objective learning structure are on a similar manner, and the contents of first chapter is PSM. So this is a new topic, maybe new for the freshers one, and it is old for the chemical industrial person. So in chemical industries or in MNCs, mainly this PSM is going to follow, but in other engineering industries or in other industries, PSM is not mandatory, or most of the companies are not following all these things or all the parameters. So in the PSM there are 20 parameters. So what is PSM? Is process safety management. So 20 parameters are given under the PSM. So we have to study all these 20 parameters in details. In the second part, major industrial disaster, what are, that is nothing but the case studies like Flixboro or Bhopal disaster, Mexico, Seveso, Sandoz vessel. These are the major disasters which are happened from 1974 to 1986, and we have to study why these industries disaster are happening or happen, and what are the root causes, then what should be the precautions or the preventive measures for not to repeat all these things. That may be technicality, that may be behavior based study, whatever it may be. Then the enhancing safety in chemical industry. So in the chemical industry is a major concern where the safety concept should be learned from each and every worker, employer, like HSE, LOPA, SEAL, etc. So there are different parameter to study, especially for the chemical industry, because the subject is for the chemical industry. The second chapter focuses on the unit operation and process hazards. So unit operation is basically a physical operation or mechanical operation where the chemical reactions are not involved, and the process hazard means where the chemical reactions are involved or the chemical characteristics are involved. So when we are using the various instruments or equipments in the chemical industry, so you should know what are the instrumentations, what are the parameters like pressure, temperature, volume, flow rate, etc., and how to overcome all these hazards or to reduce these hazards. So that is the part of second chapter. Then how to handle the chemicals, because there are different types of chemicals that may be toxic, hazardous, etc., that may be flammable or explosive. So how to handle these chemicals in a safe way. So what is mean by MSDS, that is material safety data sheet, etc. So all these parameters are given under the third chapter. Then in fourth chapter, it is the safety in plant operation and maintenance. So how to operate and maintain the chemical plant in a safer way, that is the main focus. So how to start up or shut down the chemical plant in a safer way. So some SOPs are designed for that purpose, even for the maintenance purpose, because in some chemical plants like sugar industry, there were 6 months maintenance is there. So specific or special precautionary measure should be taken for that maintenance team or for the maintenance procedures. That is the focus of fourth chapter. Then the fifth chapter is focuses on the fire and explosion. What is mean by fire? What is fire triangle concept? What is fire tetrahedron? Then what is mean by explosion? What are the types of explosion, that may be VC, UVC, BLEV, etc.? What should be done if the fire catches. It means the protection parts, then the detection or alarm system for the precautionary concepts, and if the fire catches, then how to fight that fire, how to extinguish that fire. So all these are the contents of the fifth chapter. Then sixth chapter focuses on the pressure vessels, that may be unfired or fired vessels, then the pressure system hazards and controls. So what are the pressure systems, how to control these pressure system hazards? This is the focus of sixth chapter. And again, the assignments, learning resources are given for the subject. And the next subject is environmental management, that is 23112. So again, the instruction, learning objectives, rational learning structures are of similar manner. The main contents of this environmental management 23112 is, the first chapter is focuses on the environmental management systems. So this is a new ISO technique, that is ISO 14001:2015 implemented. And what are the contents or the clauses under this ISO 14001, how to implement that, then EI concept, etc. Then the concept of common effluent treatment plant. Normally those who are working in industry, they know about the ETP, but generally very few people are knowing about the CETP. So common ETP is nothing but the CETP concept. So we are going to discuss about the parameters to maintain in the CETP in detail for that particular subject. The second chapter focuses on the environmental important legislation or regulations. So Air Act, Water Act, then State Pollution Control Board provisions, then Central Pollution Control Board provisions, then how to monitor the environmental parameters. So that may be air pollutant, water pollutant, humidity, solid waste, hazard waste, noise, etc. is the focus of the second chapter. In the third chapter, they are focusing on the waste management. So what is mean by waste? What are the categories of waste? How to tackle this waste? How to manage this waste? These are the different focuses or the parameters of third chapter. So that may be biomedical waste, that may be e-waste, battery waste, etc. Then the fourth chapter focuses on the global warming. So normally we are knowing about this concept, what is meant by carbon emission, greenhouse effect, greenhouse gases, how to control that, what are the reasons or the causes of global warming, and how to control these greenhouse gases, or what are the alternative or the solution for this global warming. Then the fifth chapter focuses on the energy conservations. So this is another part where we have to reduce the energy consumption, or we have to adopt the energy efficient technologies or the equipments or instruments for this energy conservation program. So here ISO 50001 is the technology, and some other parameters like LCA or eco-friendly environment good practices should be adopted for the energy conservation programs. That is the focus of fifth chapter. In the sixth chapter, they have mentioned about the sustainability. What is mean by sustainability? What are the sustainability reporting? What is mean by GRI? What are the GRI guidelines? So these are not the common things which are involved in regular or day-to-day practice. So some MNCs or only large-scale industries are knowing about these things, because this is the global reporting initiatives. So what are the best practices by the globe? These are the GRI guidelines. So these are the G4 guidelines we have to study in the sixth chapter. And again, the assignment list and learning structure is given in that 23112. Now this is the next one, is quality control in occupational safety and health. That is 23113. In the main contents of this 23113 is, first chapter focus on the safety appraisal and control techniques and permit to work systems. So what is meant by work permit? Why it is required? Where it is required? Where it is applicable? So that is applicable especially for the hot work, cold work, working at height, electrical installation, confined space entry, etc. So what is meant by confined space? What is meant by loto systems, etc. can be discussed in the first chapter. Then in the second chapter, what is meant by accident, incident, near miss, dangerous occurrences, etc. and what are the types of accidents, what are the terminologies involved in the accidents, what is the compensation for after the accidents to the employee, etc., and with reference to the different regulations like ESI Act, DOCW Act, Factory Act, etc. So that is the focus of second chapter. In the third chapter, we are going to calculate or evaluate the safety performance of the particular company. We can compare the safety performance parameters or the safety performance with other company, that may be system concern, that may be other company, that may be the company outside that particular city. But the comparison is focuses for the improvement in the safety aspects. So for the safety performance, there are some indicators like frequency rate, severity rate, frequency severity index, safety score, etc. We have to study these safety performance indicators. We have to study this formula for all these indicators. We have to calculate or practice some of the numericals on the basis of these indicators. And on the basis of calculations, we have to conclude that what is the safety performance of your company with reference to other companies or with reference to previous years. So there are two factors: with reference to previous, any improvement, or it is stagnant, or it is worsening a score. So that is depends on the safety performance. Normally, safety score and FSI is the main important factor where you can understand the safety performance is improving or not. Then there is a classification of industrial accidents and special cases. It is a reference. The main reference for this classification is IS 3786, and accident analysis is another part of the IS 3786. So we have to refer only IS 3786 for the accident classification. Then in fourth chapter, there is a focus on the HERA, Hazan, MCA, and other identification techniques. So HERA means hazard identification and risk assessment. Hazan means hazard analysis. MCA is the maximum credible accident analysis. Then QRA is quantitative risk assessment, and some other techniques are involved in the fourth chapter like RCA, FTA, ETA, CCA, MART, FMEA, JSA. So you should know at least the basic part, basic concept, what exactly the objective of this particular technique and the applicability of this particular technique for the incident. Then the fifth chapter focuses on the MAH control and the emergency preparedness and response system. MAH means major accident hazards, where MAH rule is there. Then there is some definitions and rules of government management and ILO practice. So emergency preparedness, there are main two cases, that is on-site emergency plan and off-site emergency plans. And these plans should be prepared for this off-site emergency as well as for on-site emergency by the industries. And some other concepts are also there, that is MARC. That MARC is nothing but mutual accident response group, and some control system by the local, state or national, international government. Then the sixth chapter focuses on the occupational health and safety audits. So we know about the audit, but this safety audit are guidelines by the IS 14489 1998, and some other audits like OSHA's 18000 2007, or ISO 45001, or ISO 18001 2007. So these are the different audits that may be conducted internally, externally, or by yourself, right? So these are the main focus of the sixth chapter. Then again, assignments and learning structure is, or references are given. The next syllabus part is 23114, that is safety, health and environmental legislation. So clearly the name itself indicates that it contains the legislation part. It means the SHE acts and rules. So you can understand this first chapter, basically it is of Factory Act only. So what is meant by Factory Act? What are the chapters involved under the Factory Act? What are the sections and how many sections are involved under the Factory Act? How many schedules are there under the Factory Act? And what are the rules under the Factory Act, like Maharashtra Factory Rule, Safety Audit Rule, etc. So this is the one of the most important Factory Act, that is the chapter for the legislation as well as for all the subject for the ADIs. Even after passing out the ADIs, you should know the Factory Act contains sections, schedules and amendments also. So the second chapter focuses on the building and other construction workers and rule of 1968, 1998, welfare rule, and the Maharashtra Fire Prevention Life Saving Act 2007. Third chapter focuses on the Environment Protection Act, that is Water Act, Air Act, Environment Protection Act, Hazardous Chemical Act, then Biomedical, Noise, E-Waste, Battery, Hazardous Waste Management Rule, Chemical Accident Rule, etc. Then the fourth chapter focuses on the SHE related important legislation like IBR, that is Indian Boiler Act, then Indian Electricity Act and Rule, Explosive Act and Rule, Petroleum Act and Rule, Calcium Carbide Act and Rule, Gas Cylinder Rule, Radiation Protection Rule, Hazardous Material Transportation Rule, SMPV, that is Static and Mobile Pressure Vessel Rule, Dock Worker Rule, etc. So you can understand or observe that these chapter containing the list of acts and rules, right? So there were no concepts or definition like this. This is specific, and this total legislation subject is a specific act or a particular section or a particular definition, particular schedule only, right? The fifth chapter focuses on the social security legislation. So again, Employee Compensation Act, ESIC, Contract Labor Act, then Public Liability Act, Responsible Care, Motor Vehicles, Central Motor Vehicle Act, Maharashtra Motor Vehicle Act, Transport of Hazardous Goods, Fire Prevention and Life Saving Act, etc. And the next chapter contains the ILO. So what is meant by ILO? That is nothing but the International Labour Organization. So in the ILO, basically it is an international labour organization. So it is international level rules, and the rules are called as convention and recommendations. So when in a first meeting, whatever the rules are designed by these international persons are called as convention, and when after feedbacks they are going to modify, rectify, or some changes are required, then it is called as recommendations. So there are ILO recommendations and conventions are there. There are lots of convention recommendation, but as far as this syllabus is concerned, we are focusing on only the ILO convention recommendations which are concerned with the SHE only. So there are near about 8 to 9 SHE ILO convention and recommendations. So we are going to focus only on that ILO convention and recommendation. Then again, the assignments and learning resources are given for this subject. The next subject is Industrial Hygiene and Occupational Health. That is 23115. So name again itself indicate that there are two parts, that is industrial hygiene and occupational health. So in this contents, the first chapter focuses on the ventilation and heat stress. So normally there are very less industries who are focusing on this industrial hygiene and occupational health. Generally the pharmaceutical, food industries, and some chemical industries or specific fine chemical industries are focusing on this particular task. But nowadays we must focus on this, or we must improve or rectify ourselves for this industrial hygiene and occupational health. The COVID situation is one of the indicator where we can understand what is the importance of mask, what is the importance of social distancing, what is the importance of housekeeping, etc. So the first chapter focuses on the ventilation and heat stress. So you know about the ventilation basic, but now here we have to study this ventilation as far as the Factory Act or MFR guidelines are given, right? What is meant by heat stress? So due to the high temperature, heat stress can be generated, but we are going to focus what are the comfortable zones, what is exactly that room temperature should be there, what is the working environment should be there, what is the limit of humidity, air circulation, etc. Then the second part is industrial lighting and lighting and illumination. So what is the light requirement? What is the lux requirement? What is meant by lux parameters? What guidelines are given by the OSHAs or other guidelines or IS standards? Then what is the noise and vibration? So noise is actually it is a hazard. So what should be the level? So in previous Factory Act and MFR, 95 decibels is given. Now it is amended, and now 85 decibels is given. So we have to control this noise below 85. That is the target should be given. And in the same way, vibrations can be measures, and that is also can be controlled. So the focus of the first chapter is clear: noise, vibration, light illumination, ventilation, and heat stress. The second chapter focuses on the industrial hygiene. So what exactly the industrial hygiene is? What is that concept? What is LEV, local exhaust ventilation, personal hygiene, housekeeping? Then what are the terminologies which are involved related to industrial hygiene, like routes of entry? So nowadays we are saying, or the government is always saying, that we must use the mask. Why? Because we have to avoid the route of entry, that is of COVID, through the respiration system, through the mouth. So these are the two ways of a respiratory system, and third one is normally the skin, and fourth one is eye. So there are routes of entry to the human systems, and some terminologies are in the industrial hygiene, like LC50, LD50, IDLS, TEL, TLV, TW, etc. So that is lethal concentration, lethal dose, imminent danger to life and health, short term imminent to danger and life, that is for TEL value for 15 minutes. Then for TLA, TW value, that is threshold limit value, time weighted average for 8 hours. Likewise, there are different concepts and examples for the industrial hygiene. Then the third part or chapter is focuses on the personal protective equipments. So normally we are knowing about the hard hats, helmets, gloves, etc. But there are two types of PPEs. One is respiratory and second is non-respiratory. So common persons are knowing about the non-respiratory PPE, but we have to study the respiratory as well as non-respiratory, and as per IS standards also, right? So it is not just I'm wearing the helmet, it means any helmet. We have to study what exactly the requirement is, what are the hazards involved and involved in that particular operation, whether it required hard hat, whether it required helmet, whether it required some particular fluorescent colors, etc. Or in some confined spaces or oxygen deficient atmosphere, what is the requirement? So that may be air purifier, that may be cartridge type or self-contained breathing apparatus, etc. So there are different hazards, there are different personal protective equipments, and depending on the hazards, working environment and your requirement, you have to select proper personal protective equipment. Then fourth one is occupational health. So what is mean by WHO? Due to COVID-19, a common person is also knowing about WHO nowadays. So World Health Organization. So it is WHO is the main body who can give the guidelines for each and every disease, especially for the industrial diseases, especially for this pandemic like COVID-19, etc. So what are the measures or monitoring techniques involved under the occupational health? What are the rules and regulation where we can refer these occupational health parameters? What is mean by medical officer? What is mean by certifying surgeons? What are their qualification criteria or eligibility criteria for this particular post? Where the ambulance is required? Where the first aid is required? What is mean by occupational health center? What is the requirement for that OHC, etc.? All these things are given under this fourth chapter. Then the fifth chapter focuses on the first aid. So what is mean by first aid? What is first aid training? What are the first aid trainers? What are the contents or the parameters involved under the first aid training? What is mean by CPR? What are the first aid boxes? All these parameters or the things are given in the first aid. Then sixth chapter, I have already discussed this ergonomics. So this is the Greek word. Ergo is different and nomos is different. So the gestures or posture or your working style related diseases, especially for the musculoskeletal disorders or the other diseases due to these wrong gestures or postures. So this study is under the ergonomic. So definitions, then objective or main purpose of this particular ergonomical study, what are the solutions under this ergonomical study. So there are different tests or physiology is available, like respiration test, or you can say that is work capacity test. Then some determination techniques or instruments are also available like ergometer, treadmill, etc. And you can test yourself for oxygen capacity, that may be breathing capacity, that may be pulse rate, or some stresses or strength of your body parts. So all this study is involved under this particular chapter. Then again, learning resources and references are given. Now the last, that is ninth one, is the head. It is not a subject. So all these eight theory subjects are involved above, where 2310 is the starting and 23115 is the last subject. Now in this project, what is expected? So you can do your project on your particular topic, but you must do the project which is related to the safety, health and environment, right? So you have to focus a particular or subtopic. Like in the safety aspects, if you are going to focus on the fire prevention protection program or fire mock drill or some emergency drill, you can do that. Or in the environment, if you want to do some work for the ETP or CETP or STP also, you can do that. In the ergonomics also, under the ergonomics, you can study some processes where the if you change some gesture posture, if you say change some table height or chair height or the computer system distance or the brightness, etc., you can do anything. But whatever you are doing, that should be written on the paper. Some results, experimentation and conclusion should be there. And after the conclusion, even you can add the future scope, because after doing this study, I have done this, these are the experimentation, these are the results. But in the conclusion, you can say that if you go by second way, then the result may be like this. So that particular project can be continuous on a next year or by the another student. So these are the basic guidelines. All the guidelines are given in this way. These are the different parameters. What should be the project contents, like title of the project work, acknowledgement, preface, certification from the organization is must. Then certificate from the student that project has been done by him. Executive summary, index contents, aim, objective, methodology, introduction, organization, company details, then SHE of SHE activities of this company, then some observation and finding, summary and recommendation, references. And these are the references, means these are the standard references, international standard references, bibliography, and some key learning in industrial safety after the project. So these are the guidelines given by the MSBT for the project report, right? So you can start your project report or you can start your project work from day one also. And these are the learning structure which is given under this project. So you can do all these things in a proper way by strategic planning, and then only you can understand what exactly. Now it is a fact that some students are of different background. If you are a chemical engineer, then the chemical and process safety may be the subject which is very useful for you. If you are a mechanical engineer, then the safety and engineering industry is a subject where you know all these processes or the operations involved or the safety measures or SOP. If you are electrical engineer, then electrical hazards, electrical acts and rules you may know. If you are environmental engineer, then the environment technology is a subject where you can focus for the score, right? So these are the different aspects. If you are civil engineer, then the construction safety may be the subject where you can focus for the scoring. So it is depend on your background, depend on your job profile, and depending on your experience. So you have to decide now what should be the focus. If you are weak in chemistry or in chemical aspects, then you have to focus on the chemical and process safety. If you are weak in remembering techniques or recalling technique, then you have to focus on the legislation part, that is acts and rules, because there is no scope in the acts and rules. you have to remember that in the Factory Act there are 120 sections, there are 4 schedules, there are 9